Welcome to a new series on the channel where I take aim at some of the biggest cooks' recipes and try to improve them based on taste, texture, cost, or speed, then do a side-by-side taste test at the end. First up is Kenji Lopez Alt's Chicken Chickpea Burgers. He recently posted about these burgers made with ground chicken and chickpeas, which as soon as I saw them, I had to give them a try. They yield a very interesting texture and are simply seasoned with a nice bite. The question is though, how would I improve them? Hey everybody, I'm Ethan, a home cooking nerd who likes to find better ways to cook and share them with all of you, which is exactly what we're gonna be doing in this new series. Now, by my estimation, there's kind of four main areas where we can actually improve our cooking. Number one is make food that tastes better. Number two is make food that has a better texture. Number three, make food that tastes just as great, but it's done in less time. Or number four, you make food that again is just as great, but it's done cheaper. I mean, who doesn't love saving a couple of bucks? So for each recipe that we look at in this series, we can choose just one of those categories to improve upon or potentially all four. And this is all in the hopes of becoming a better cook. Now, cooking and enjoying food is inherently a subjective topic. For example, I could tell you that a smash burger has more flavor compounds created through the Maillard reaction than a standard burger, and I may think that this tastes way better. But if your mom and dad made your burgers different growing up and that's what you were used to, you could tell me to go to hell and say your way is better. So for the recipes that we do, I'll not only tell you what I'm doing, but also why I'm doing it with some resources and food science stuff to give you an explanation of why I'm trying to improve it and how it should actually affect the final product when we do a side-by-side taste test. But with all that being said, let's hop into the first recipe. Kenji Lopez's chicken and chickpea burgers. So for Kenji's recipe posted in this newsletter, it's pretty simple. Cooked chickpeas are first mashed into a bowl, then mixed with lean ground chicken, finely chopped onion, and salt and pepper to taste. They are formed into even-sized patties, a little bit larger than the bun, then pan-seared in some oil. Add some cheese on top to melt, get your toasted bun, add some mayo, tomato, lettuce, the burger, a little bit more mayo or whatever else you want to add, and there you have it, a nice, delicious chickpea chicken burger. It's great as is, but here are the areas that I would like to try and improve. My main focus of improvement will be on the taste and texture by using techniques that make it more like a beef burger. From the Food Lab by the same Kenji Lopez, he defines a hamburger as a patty of pure ground beef with no salt, seasonings, or additives mixed into it. The key is that the salt and pepper should only go on the exterior, and the texture should be loose, tender, and juicy, which is what I'm missing from this current version. You see, by using lean ground chicken and chickpeas as the base, you don't really get any fat that is normally in a burger made with, say, 80-20 beef, helping create that loose, tender, and juicy texture. Also, by adding salt directly to the meat mixture, it creates something a little bit more sausage-like with a uniform texture. So here's how I'm going to change it. First, I'm going to ground my own chicken. I grabbed some chicken thighs, separated the bones, skin, and meat. Then I'll be using 90% by weight chicken thighs and 10% chicken skin for grinding in the food processor. Adding the fat through the chicken skin should lend to juiciness and richness. Additionally, I'll only be adding salt and pepper to the exterior, just like a traditional burger. And if we take a quick look at the patties, here is a side-by-side comparison. The one on the right using the lean ground chicken is kind of springy and uniform due to no fat in it and adding the salt and mixing it right in. However, the one on the left where I ground my own chicken, you can see that it's got this nice loose texture that is much closer to a typical beef burger, and that is due to the addition of that fat from the chicken skin, and obviously we only salted the outside. Texture out of the way, let's focus on taste. An additional benefit of adding fat is that it provides more flavor. Again, from the Food Lab, Kenji notes that fat is where most of the flavor of the meat comes from. For our burger, it will make the chicken burger taste more like chicken. Outside of that, these can be really customized to whatever flavor you want. Kenji notes this in his article with options like the barbecue or green chili and cheese chickpea chicken burgers, so this isn't an improvement per se, just preference. For me, I'm a sucker for smoked paprika and some hot chili powder, so that's what I added to my mix. And then for my burger accoutrements, again, more preference. I'll be using a dill garlic lemon yogurt sauce, some pickled onions, lettuce, and tomato. So obviously, since I'm going after better taste and texture through grinding my own meat, this recipe is not gonna be faster than just getting store-bought ground chicken. However, it may be a little bit cheaper, but that's not gonna be the focus of this video, so I'm not gonna do a cost breakdown. Anyways, I think it's time to make these damn things and do our taste test. To start, separate two chicken thighs into skin, meat, and bones. The leftover bones can be used for stock. You're going to cut each chicken thigh into roughly 1-inch chunks. Then, using a scale, weigh out how much chicken meat you have, and for me, I had about 11 ounces. So to make that into that 90% lean and 10% fat split, I need about an extra ounce of chicken skin. You're gonna spread out the lean meat and skin on a baking sheet and just toss this into a freezer for 15 minutes. This will allow the chicken to firm up and not smear when we grind it in the food processor. While we're waiting, let's prepare the yogurt sauce. Add 100 grams of yogurt to a bowl along with 2 cloves of minced garlic, a shaving of lemon zest, 1/2 juice of lemon, along with some salt and pepper to taste. And I almost forgot, also add a small spoonful of dillweed. Simple and delicious. You can also remove the top of your can of chickpeas and strain them out. After about 15 minutes, we can pull our chicken out of the freezer, and this is what the skin will look like after about 15 minutes. Now, we're gonna place the partially frozen chicken thighs and skin into the bowl of a food processor and pulse it about 10 to 15 times until a ground chicken mixture forms. You're gonna test the grind by picking some up with your hands and seeing if you can form it into a ball. Note that this chicken could also be hand chopped into ground meat as I did with my chicken nugget recipe. Now to a large mixing bowl, we're gonna add 1/2 can of those chickpeas and start mashing them with a fork until no large chickpeas remain. Once that's done, add in 8 ounces of the ground chicken, some finely minced onion, smoked paprika, and chili powder. You're gonna mix this with your hands until a loose homogeneous mixture forms. Once mixed, get a little bowl and splash some water on your hands to help prevent sticking. You're gonna form the chicken and chickpea mixture into 3 1/4-pound burgers, and you wanna make them a little bit wider than your bun with an indentation as that will help them from shrinking while cooking. Once formed, again sticking with that classic burger technique, you're gonna generously salt and pepper the exterior of the burgers. At the stove, set a cast iron over medium heat, and you're just gonna add in maybe a teaspoon of peanut oil just to help them fry up. Once that's hot, place the patty away from you, and you're gonna cook until it is browned and the exterior starts to crisp up about 3 minutes on each side. Flip the burger and cook for another 3 or so minutes. At the last minute, you can add the cheese to help it melt, and then you wanna pull the burgers off when the internal temperature is 165 and it is nicely browned on both sides, and now we can assemble. Place the toasted brioche bun down, and then slather on some of that yogurt sauce and 3 slices of tomato. Now I'm gonna add my leaf lettuce and top that with the burger with cheese and add a bunch of those pickled onions on top. Lastly, add more yogurt sauce to your top bun and flip that over onto the top. A beautiful and delicious looking chicken chickpea burger. Let's do the taste test. All right, everyone, it's finally time for the taste test. Let's give these a go. So we'll do Kenji's first. So this one, great burger on its own. Now let's try mine and compare those differences. It's honestly crazy just the difference in the texture of those patties from doing the fresh ground chicken where we mixed in our own fat through the chicken skin and then we did salt only on the exterior versus the one that was pre-mixed and used ground chicken that was very lean that didn't have extra fat in it. You get a nice like springy texture, and like this is fine, it's not bad by any means, but if I'm like after that burger texture, 1000% this one is better. I mean, just overall better mouthfeel. And then, I mean, I added my own little flavors that I always love. So pickled onions, made a little bit of a yogurt sauce. I mean, you could add whatever you want to these to make them delicious. But this one for me, you gotta go with the fresh ground chicken. And
Another thing I was actually thinking about while I was making this, that this is actually more convenient, even though I am grinding my own meat, because I always have chicken thighs in the fridge. Like, if I go to the grocery store that week, I have chicken thighs in the fridge. They're like the one protein that I always get just because I know I can make a million things out of them. Ground chicken, on the other hand, I don't buy ground chicken unless like there would be something that I would have to. So it'd have to be like a special trip for me. So if like I decided I wanted to make these, I would already have the chicken thighs. But if I wanted to make it with ground chicken, I don't already have that. So I'd actually have to run to the store. And then by the time I, you know, take my 15-minute walk there, 15-minute walk back, I would have already been able to ground up my chicken. So it's not really saving me any time unless you buy your ground chicken already. But that's just for how I cook. That's not most people. I'll just buy components and things and then go from there. But this one is the ticket. But that is going to wrap it up for this one. Drop down comments below on recipes that you want me to try with your favorite creators. And we'll go from here. Hopefully this was pretty informational, just to see how different techniques affect the textures of burgers. And for me, these videos are very interesting to make. And I love comparing things and trying to understand the why behind certain recipes. So hopefully you guys enjoy the series. Also, thank you to all my Patreons. I do have a Patreon. I know I don't talk about it much. But thank you to all my Patreons who have supported me thus far. We're growing on the channel, and I'm looking forward to a big move this summer. I feel like we're just getting started. That's going to wrap it up for this one. I'll catch you in the next one. Peace.